Just going to go through a quick video now of how to use the Ordnance Survey Maps app for your smartphone, the OS Maps app. On the right hand side you can see a view of my phone, and on the left hand side of the screen you can see a browser with the OS Maps app. Now I'm logged in to both at the moment, both logged in on my phone on the right hand side and logged in on the left. You can just see where the cursor is flashing up there. It shows you that you're logged in. And I can see the OS Leisure Maps. If you go down to the map symbol, bottom right, I can see the OS Leisure Maps symbol, 1 to 25 and 1 to 50 of the whole of the UK. So if you can't see a map appear, just check you're logged in and your subscription's up to date. Now on the right hand side, I'll show you my phone. You can create a route on your phone. So let's say, for example, we're going around the Langdales and we wanted to create a route. You can search at the top for an area, click on search and put in your destination, and then it'll send to the map around where you've searched for. So here you can see we're around the New Dungeon Gill Hotel, and I'll just pinch the screen and zoom a little bit and you can see there up to Stickletown and Pavey Arch. So if I wanted to create a route on my phone, I click menu and create a route at the top and choose what type of route I want. I'm going to do a walking route, and then you can just simply move the screen around with a long press, click on with your finger and start to plot the route. So I'm going to plot the route there up. We're going to go up to Pavey Arch and do Pavey Arch. Now, it's quite easy to do, but on your screen you might find that pressing with your finger is not particularly accurate. So if you want to, you can do the whole route on your phone and save it onto your phone there. Or alternatively, you can do it on your computer and then sync up with your phone. So I'll show you how to do that. So just cancel that route for a moment and discard that route. And I'll go over to the OS Maps app website, logged on here on my browser. So I'll go into, I've searched for where I want to be, so I'm actually in Langdales, and then I'm going to just say create a custom route up there. You can search for routes to see if other people have done them for the area, or you can create your own. Now, first feature to note is this snap-on. So in national parks it will automatically try and do the route for you, the easiest and shortest route. However, you might find that's not exactly where you want to go. So to do your own route and not let the app suggest the route for you, turn snap off. There you go, the horseshoe's now off. So I'm going to plot my own route now. So I'm going to click the start here at the pub, and I'm just going to click up here, cross Stickle Gill, and plot my route up to the dam, and I'm going to go round here just quickly. I'm not going to go up Pavey Arch, I'm just going to go straight up on top. So I've missed out Jack's Rake, just going straight on top of Pavey Arch there. And then we'll go around here. And then off back down to Langdale and back to the pub. Now, one tip for the route here, as you can see, it's quite thick. So when you print this off or look at it on your phone, it might be difficult to see the detail underneath. So I always recommend here, just change the style of the route. Click on the style icon up here and thin it down a bit and increase the transparency so you can see underneath your route. I'll now save the route. Click on save. And I'm going to call it Langdale OS Maps app Pavey Arch. There you go. And I'm going to let everyone see it. So it's 5.8 kilometers, 2 hours, 15 minutes. Save that. Click on done. And now that route, if I close that route down, and now look at routes, my routes, you will see if I put newest first, that map has been stored by Ordnance Survey in the cloud to my user space. And if we now go over to this side and have a look at the phone, if I do menu now and look at routes in the middle there, click on routes, there's at the top the Langdale route, and I can click on that and it opens the routes up, and you can see exactly the same route that I've just created on my computer. Now, top tip here is before you leave to go on the hill, make sure you've downloaded the map to your phone, because if you've not got mobile signal or Wi-Fi signal and the map's not been downloaded to your phone, you'll just have a white space with a blue dot in the middle, which is not much use. So download the map, click on the download map symbol there, choose your map. I want 1-25 OS Explorer, click on that, and now it's downloading the map area to the phone. Once it's 100% loaded, then next time I go and pick up that route, so if I just go back to routes and click there, you can see it says in green, map downloaded, and that's very important because that means the map's local to my phone and I will be able to view the map when I'm not connected to the internet or the mobile cell. Click on the route, and if you want to, you can click on follow route, and it will basically indicate to you when you're on the route with the dot, and also give you a notification when you're off route on your mobile phone. One last thing about the mobile phone. Obviously, if you're using it for navigation on the hill, it's also your primary means of communication. So make sure you take a full battery charged, and preferably a cable and a spare battery charging unit on the hill, and keep it in a plastic bag. Okay, hope that helps. If you've got any questions about the OS Maps app or navigation, please email us at Ultimate Navigation School, and have a great time on the hill. Bye-bye.